being used right now in the legal industry is still, I would say, in the Flintstone stage. We're going to be in the Jetson stage, I think, probably quicker than we expect, maybe in the next 36 months, 5 years at the latest. We are not nearly as advanced as our healthcare counterparts in using artificial intelligence. Where we're starting to use it is with things like basic document review, when we're doing deals on transactions, when we are looking at contracts, the really more basic type of stuff that candidly has been stuff that, with due respect, has been done by a lot of paralegals and not necessarily attorneys over the last 50 or 60 years. But what concerns me is that you're going to have a whole bunch of people coming out of law school with huge loans, which we already know is a crisis, and they're going to be outsourced by this artificial intelligence. And I don't know that anyone's warning them of that. There's this myth of a prepackaged lawyer, I call it. Guess what, folks? When folks come out of law school, you know what we're prepared to do? Pass the bar exam if we're hopefully lucky. Not to be lawyers. So you're going to have a whole bunch of folks come out, pass the bar exam, and find out that the job that the law firm is hiring them, really the AI is more qualified than they are. When are they going to then get that experience they need to get over years to grow in a profession? I think that ultimately this is going to have a major, major impact on law school attendance. And maybe this is a good thing. Maybe it's going to right size what's gotten out of control, which is a lot of folks going to law school, a lot of people taking out loans that, quite frankly, they probably wish they hadn't. The statistics show that. And maybe we're going to have a resetting as to who actually wants to make a career out of being an attorney as compared to going to law school because they wanted to do something after college and didn't want to do something else.